Let my head not refuse it. For still my prayer is against the deeds of the wicked. Their judges are overthrown by sides of the cliff, and they hear my words, for they are sweet.
Our bones are scattered at the mouth of the grave, as when one ploughs and breaks up the earth.
Afflicted very much, revive me, O Lord, according to your word.
But my eyes are upon you, O God, the Lord. In you I take refuge. Do not leave my soul destitute.
Keep me from the snares they have laid for me, and from the traps of the workers of iniquity. Let the wicked fall into their own pits, while I escape safely.
I cry out to the Lord with my voice. With my voice to the Lord I make my supplication.
I pour out my complaint before him. I declare before him my trouble.
My spirit was overwhelmed. Within me then you knew my path.
In the way in which I walk, they have secretly set a snare for me.
Look on my right hand and see, for there is no one who acknowledges me. Refuge has failed me, no one cares for my soul.
I cried out to you, O Lord, I say, you are my refuge, my portion in the land of the living.
Attend to my cry, for I am brought very low. Deliver me from my persecutors, for they are stronger than me.
Bring my soul out of prison, that I may praise your name. The righteous shall surround me, for you shall deal bountifully with me.
Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path.
I have sworn and confirmed that I will keep your righteous judgments.
I am afflicted very much. Revive me, O Lord, according to your word.
Accept, I pray, the freewill offerings of my mouth, O Lord, and teach me your judgments.
My life is continually in my hand, yet I do not forget your law.
The wicked have laid a snare for me, yet I have not strayed from your precepts.
Your testimonies I have taken as a heritage forever, for they are the rejoicing of my heart.
I am inclined my heart to perform your statutes forever to the very end.
Praise the Lord, all you Gentiles. Love him, all you proud people.
For his merciful kindness great towards us, and the truth of the Lord endures forever. Bless
me,
O Lord.
Thank you. with God, that no one at all more, with fast fall. Did not our heart burn within us? us, while he talked with us on the road, and while he opened the scriptures to us. So they rose up that very hour and returned to Jerusalem and found the 11 and those who were with them gathered together, saying, "The Lord is risen indeed and has appeared to Simon." And they talked about the things that had happened on the road and how he was known to them in the breaking of bread. Now, as they said these things, Jesus himself stood in the midst of them and said to them, "Peace to you." But they were terrified and frightened, and supposed they had seen a spirit. And he said to them, "Why are you troubled, and do doubts arise in your hearts? Before my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Handle me and see, for a spirit does not have flesh and bones as you see I have." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. But while they still did not believe for joy and marvel, he said to them, "Have you any food here?" So they gave him a piece of a broiled fish and some honeycomb, and he took it and ate in their presence. Then he said to them, "These are the words which I spoke to you while I was still with you, that all the things must be fulfilled which were written in the law of Moses and the prophets and the psalm concerning me." And he opened their understanding that they might comprehend the scripture. Hear the end of the gospel. Shlomo Shaino.
Praneshuan Shihadara Drachma Indodeho Dharmimo Chaboyaknam Haudina Zahamana Tulo Kato Menafro Shilimo Devyatna Tukikotla Vishu Zahamana Adisha
Father, by whom all things were made, for us men.
kingdom shall have mine. And we believe in all His Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life to all, who proceeds from the Father, together with the Father and the Son, is worshipped and glorified, who spoke to the prophets and the apostles, and in one holy Catholic and apostolic church, we confess one baptism for the remission of sins, and we look for the resurrection of the dead, the new life and world to come. Amen. Baruch Mok.
Sin and transgressed your command, you then condemned him to death And when he went to teach us the following of these, his sin increased and intensified due to his disobedience. When you saw, O good one, that death was feeding on all of us, bringing complete perdition on the human race, and this hunger was insatiable, you then, by the intercession of God the Word, your only begotten Son, whom you delivered to death, becoming a peace offering to you, God the Father made corrupt null and void, abolish death, establish the living, and confirm the true hope of the resurrection in the souls of the faithful. Therefore, O Lord, we pray and beseech you on behalf of your high priest, Ignatius Zakharias I, who has departed from this transitory life and has reached you. Grant repose to his soul and to all the saints who were pleasing to you of old time. Remit and forgive all his human transgressions, which he committed willingly and unwillingly, wittingly and unwittingly. If you remember our transgressions, who can stand in your presence? Because absolution proceeds from you. Therefore, O Lord, grant rest to your servant in heaven, and have mercy upon us who remain on earth. Bring him safe to the blissful mansions which you promised to those who love you, because you are the Lord of the living and the dead. To you we offer praise, and to your Father, and to your living Holy Spirit, now and always and forever, Baruch Mordechai Bon Vishnu Shone.
Shalom Pavir, Kusayat Haudel Shukran Adachkoi, Betray Honol Min Olam Olmi.
Oh, man.
For the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must be on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your sting? O Sheol, where is your victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who has given us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast and movable always, abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord, but it
appoint him over all that he has. If a bad servant should say in his heart, my Lord will delay his coming, and should begin to beat his fellow servants, and to eat and drink with drunkard, the Lord of that servant will come on a day when he does not expect him, and at an hour that he does not know. And he will severely scourge him, and give him a portion like that of the hypocrites. There will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Shaina v'shlomol kulku.
Please be seated.
My dear brothers, your eminences, very reverend, reverend fathers, deacons, brothers and sisters, we gather this evening to thank God Almighty for the life and the service of our father in the Lord, the late Patriarch, His Holiness, Mor Ignatius Zakia I, who almost 40 days ago left this earthly life to join his predecessors, the great patriarchs of the Holy See of Antioch, to reach his heavenly abode in paradise, and to be to gather together with the righteous of all times, those who please the Lord God from the beginning. We gather to celebrate a life of prayer, a life of dedication, and a life of giving, the late Patriarch served the Holy Church of Antioch for 34 years as Patriarch, and over 50 years as a bishop since his consecration to the Archdiocese of Mosul in Iraq in 1963. A long time for a servant of the Lord, knowing how demanding this position is, and knowing the role of a bishop in our church, which is not only a spiritual role, but it's a role of a father to the community, someone who is regarded as the responsible for the whole affairs of the community, whether it's spiritual, temporal, financial, social, any kind of problems, our people would go to their bishop, and rightly so, because the bishop is God's appointed pastor of their souls, and from him their salvation is demanded. Therefore, the late Patriarch, who served his diocese of Mosul for 6 years, acquiring the love and the respect of all the people there, he was later transferred to Baghdad, the capital of Iraq, for another 11 years. And over there in Baghdad, His Holiness, while a bishop, while an archbishop, worked hard to serve his people spiritually, by establishing many spiritual organizations for the youth as well as for the adults, and by representing the Holy Church at regional and international conferences, and going back to his diocese to put into practice what he had learned from these international events and from these Christian churches and organizations that he visited. And when the time came for him to ascend the holy throne of Antioch, God's calling to his servant was very clear and loud. He was elected by the Holy Synod to lead the church, and he was enthroned on September 14, 1980. At a time when our church was going through turbulences, the least of which was the mass migration of our people from the Middle East, the wars in the Middle East, and the divisions in our church in India. His Holiness, through the grace of God, was able to keep the church together. He was able to serve the Church of God with humility and with dedication. He was known for his affection to everyone. He would receive and bless all those who visited him, and he would be very generous in his love and affection to all his children without any discrimination. Therefore, he was able to acquire the love and the loyalty of the entire church, as well as many faithful people of sister churches. Visitors from other churches were especially impressed by his love and his humility. And they would come back from his visit saying, "Wow, what a great man he is. What a loving father he is." And when it came to his own children, he spared no efforts to help them as much as he could. During his patriarchal ministry, he ordained and consecrated for the church more than around 55 bishops and archbishops, and hundreds of priests and monks. He truly built up the spiritual life of the church after a period that followed great events which weakened the church immensely during the massacres of our people in Ottoman Turkey. Together with the Armenians, we lost over 500,000. The church came out of that period, that dark period, beaten and broken. Many dioceses were abolished. Many clergy were martyred. And the church had to pull itself together again and to establish itself again. First, the efforts of the late Patriarch Moron Ignatius Ephraim I, who was not even able to go to his patriarchy in Deir Zafaran, therefore he remained in Homs, Syria. He worked hard to provide for the refugees. He bought pieces of land here and there and built little homes for these homeless people who were forced out of their cities and villages in Turabin, in Diyarbakir, in Mardin, in Urfa, and other areas. That great man, Patriarch Ephraim Barsoom, was also a great scholar who uncovered the treasures of the Syriac Orthodox Church, brought into light the many manuscripts and the many books and writings of the church fathers which were unknown until then. And he truly became a great scholar. Therefore, he was called as the quickener of the church during that time. He is the one who gave life to the church again. He brought back the glory of the church. He made the people proud of their church. And when he passed away in 1957, his successor, the late Patriarch Ignatius, Mor Ignatius Jacob III, who was as a monk, who spent many years, almost 13 years in India, in Malankara as a monk. And when he ascended the Holy Throne of Antioch, the unity of the church in Malankara was his priority. And he worked hard with many peace-loving people in Malankara to bring back peace, which unfortunately did not last for long. But he tried his best to show that the church is a loving mother for all its children, no matter where they live and no matter what race they belong to. After all, it is a universal church. Patriarch Yaakov was able to visit the diocese of the church scattered throughout the world and to pull people together, to inspire them through his fiery sermons and his able leadership. He was able to organize the church to continue the achievements of his predecessor. And in 1980, the Lord chose Mor Severios Zeka, the Archbishop of Baghdad and Basra, to lead the church. And through that choice, the Lord showed again that he is truly with his church, that the Lord will send to his church people who are willing and ready to sacrifice and to dedicate themselves for the salvation of their, of the members of the church and for the growth of the faith and the build-up of his holy church. Patriarch Zeka was able to unite the holy church around his patriarchal service and dignity. He was able to unite all the bishops in the Holy Synod, and he was remarkable in attracting the young people to be ordained priests and to be made monks and eventually become bishops, many of whom are serving as bishops. Patriarch Zeka was able to talk to his followers with the language of love, compassion, and humility. Even through translations, at many times when he was talking to them in language that they would not understand, they would look at him and admire his affection. Tonight, not to mourn him, but to celebrate him, to make his memory eternal, and to pray to the Lord God Almighty to bless us all through the prayers of our Holy Father, Patriarch Zeka. Brothers and sisters, when we gather together to pray for our spiritual leaders, we do so because we appreciate how much they suffered on behalf of the flock. We do so because we know their dedication to the Lord and to their church. We gather to celebrate their achievements and to learn from them, just as St. Paul commands us to look at the end of their life and learn from them. And I can truly say with full confidence that we all can learn from His Holiness Patriarch Zeka to be humble and loving. And as we commemorate the 40th day of his passing away, we ask the Lord God Almighty to shine his divine face upon his servant, our patriarch, to reward him with his heavenly rewards, with the faithful stewards of his kingdom, and to help us all through the prayers of our Holy Father, that we may, all of us, work out our salvation with the fear of God and be worthy of that end which is proper and pleasing to God, that we may all of us gather at the feet of Christ our Lord and be included among his saints in his heavenly kingdom. Amen. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, my duty and pleasure to thank all of you for attending this memorial service, especially my dear brothers, the Archbishops, His Eminence Marcellarius Abraham, who is the senior Archbishop of our church in India currently, who arrived yesterday in the United States. I'd like also to thank my dear brother, Archbishop Martin Tosiandro, who has been my partner and friend in serving this community of our Syriacal Church in America for the last 10 years. My dear brother Mor Salvanos Ayub, who is the Archbishop of our Knanaya community here in America, part of the Knanaya Archdiocese in India. And my dear brothers, who are not strangers to us, but who are also our partners in the ministry and brothers in the heritage of Antioch, His Grace Bishop Nicholas Ozon, representing the Antiochian Christian Archdiocese, who is also mourning and celebrating the life of its shepherd, our dear brother, the late Metropolitan Philip. May God bless his soul. I'd like also to thank our dear friend, Bishop Gregory Mansour of our Syriac Maronite Eparchy of St. Maroon in Brooklyn and in the eastern part of America. Sayyidina Gregory is always with us, and we appreciate his presence tonight also. I thank all of you, brothers and sisters, my brothers, the clergy who represent sister churches, Father Simeon from the Eastern Diocese of the Armenian Apostolic Church, and as we commemorate this day of the passing of our beloved patriarch, we also together commemorate the millions of martyrs who gave their life for their faith. May God bless us through their prayers. I'd like also to thank all the clergy who are with us representing sister churches and our own clergy from both the Eastern Archdiocese and Malankara Archdiocese, as well as the Knanaya Archdiocese. May God bless you all and may He reward you all through the prayers of our Holy Father, Patriarch Zakiah, and through the prayers and intercession of St. Mark the Evangelist, whose feast we celebrate today and is also the patron saint of this cathedral. May God bless you. Please stand up for the conclusion of the prayer.
Oh,
دوشم طرعي فرديشو وانزيرو العمالة من يمين غنبان لغدغ شرحا مريا
قول أبو نظر والروح فديشا
هاليلويا نهار قد قبلت من أخبار الله نظر قفرت وتمرت أخاب جابي شطموني ثمومي حيلو
Thank you.